Dearly beloved, my loving greetings to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Look, this is a beautiful place, serene surroundings, and there are several wonderful places and palaces here in Ooty. In those days, kings have built palaces and lived luxurious lives, and today there's a situation where many people come and stay in those palaces. Yet this place was developed during the period of British. So someone had toiled to develop this so wonderfully. That's why we have to visit such places, admire and enjoy them. And similarly, God has created this world so beautifully, wanted us men to live our lives happily here and enjoy everything. That's why He has given us this wonderful world. Just like these, you must also visit beautiful creations of God, such as this beautiful place, hill stations, etc. at least once a year, like I do. It is good for you to visit such places for a few days, to stay here along with your family, to sit together as a family, praising God as you enjoy the beauty of His creations. Will give you immense joy in your hearts, and God Himself will be happy because we are grateful to God as we say, God has created this for us. Our God is a God who knows us. Sometimes we tend to think that none in your house knows about you, none understands you. There are many who are worried and saying, not even my husband understands me, my wife doesn't understand me, my parents never understand me. Maybe you're thinking like that and are suffering. There are many children and young boys who are worried. So if you are one of those who are thinking like this, that none knows me nor they try to understand me, then just note what God says in Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 5. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. God says, it is I who formed you in your mother's womb, and I have known you even before I formed you. What a wonderful God He is, you see. Others could know about us only after we are born and as we grow up. But God says, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Which means the blueprint of our life is in His hands. He knows what would be our nature, our thoughts, contemplations of our hearts, etc. So when we have such a wonderful God, why should you worry that none is understanding you or none knows you? God says, son, daughter, am I not the one who created you? I know you very well. I am the God who understands you. Then why should you worry? So-and-so didn't understand me. This is troublesome for many. Yet it doesn't matter if anyone understands you or not, for the God who created you understands you well. Jesus knows your state of mind today, the fear you've harbored in you, the weariness, the worries, and several kinds of questions within you, etc. And He will surely answer you. Please open up your hearts and speak to God, is what I tell you today. This is what I teach you. Open up your hearts and speak to God. Wake up early in the morning to sit at His feet, meditate His words, and pray. You are the God who knows me. Only you, O God, can understand me. Therefore, I tell about all my burdens to you. Just try to open your heart and try talking to Him, and you'll know that there's a great joy in your hearts, and your life would turn into a sweet one, because this God will lead you so wonderfully. Will you submit yourself into His hands? Will you submit yourself to open up your hearts to Him and speak to Him every day? Just say, dear Father, you know me, though none knows me or not. You are the God who knows me and understands me. I submit myself into your presence. Please guide me. You are enough for me. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Amen.